Not by this church. I'm sorry. Let's not. I'm sorry. I know too much. Because don't you see? I think that it would bring up their shadow behavior to them. There have been a lot of abuses, especially within the Catholic Church, but not only the Catholic Church. The Protestants have their hands in the pie, so to speak, and the cockerel pie. And it does seem to me that for the Church to embrace homosexuality, then they'd have to raise their hand and look at the desires within the priesthood itself. There is so much sexual and spiritual denial. I thought of it as a spiritual eroticism that is lacking. Because, of course, the early church fathers got rid of and edited a lot of Jesus' early teaching, which you can find in some of the Gnostic Gospels. Because they edited that out and only allowed us to get a Christianity that was based on a male authority, where they knew that in order to control, they'd have to subjugate. And if you subjugate people across the board, particularly women and gay men, then the shame element is created. Women have been fighting for a long, long time to be able to integrate their sexual and their spiritual self. If you look at how much porno there is, a lot of women will say to me in confidence, I cannot have a sexual relationship unless I step into my hardcore porno self. I'm top shelf. That's the only way I can happen in the bedroom. So you and I go back to, unless they're subjugated sexually, they can't come. Now think about that. How is that any different? I said it jokingly, but it wouldn't surprise me if a dark side, you know, the black ops of the Catholic Church or even the Protestant Church created the porno industry, because it's a way, don't you see, to keep subjugated and segregated, the sexual self and the spiritual self integrated. And I'm always trying to say, the two Marys, we're divided as Christian women. You either step into the Magdalene, who was, she was stripped of her spirituality, or you step into the Mother Mary, who her sexuality was circumcised from her. She couldn't be sexual, even with her other children that she had besides Jesus. Even if you want to stay with the virgin thing, although we know virgin means a whole different thing than the vulva being unimpeded. But if you step into that, you have to think, okay, so this woman had these other children. Well, how did she get those then? Did God do it with her too? Well, why don't we hear about them? Where's the angel Gabriel with the other four? Isn't that worth talking about? Or the other three? I'm not sure. So what I'm saying is, women have had, in Christianity, it's one Mary or the other. And I've been trying to, I think we talked about it, marry the Marys within the being. And that is the way to wholeness within you as a being, as a woman. As a male, you have to do this with your own poetry. But the idea of the church embracing homosexuality, I don't see it happening because of what it will bring up in them. Why should you want to be part of a path that's in so much denial of what you believe in? That means you're trying to be part of a belief that doesn't believe in you. I don't want to be part of it. I'm not banging on the Catholic Church trying to accept me. I'm banging on the door saying, give some relief to these poor women who are having 9 children, half of them are dying. You're creating murder. You are murdering these children because you won't let the women have birth control. There's so much blood on your hands, brothers. Why don't we sit together, hold hands, and speak? I'm a daughter of the church as well as a daughter of the earth. But I am a daughter of the earth, and I will not stop speaking because the earth is crying for her children. And what these mothers are having to do, the shackles that they're in, and my father will sit here right with me and say everything I just said about the birth control and the shackles, because believe it or not, my dad is a Christian feminist, but he is a minister, and he can't get away from the four gospels, and he will embrace my homosexual friends, men and women, but he will have a hard time because he is trapped in the gospels that were edited, trying to see it as, you know, this is the law. And I have to tell you this, he and I had this little funny moment when he and my mother were running my publishing, which they did forever. And he created this anthology years ago because he was running the, you know, the sheet music side with music sales. And so I got it and I said, Dad, there's no crucify, there's no God. I mean, these are singles, you know, they should be there. There's no Father Lucifer, that's a choice. There's no professional widow. Why? He said, well, I was the editor. And I said, okay, let's talk about who edited the New Testament. This is what I'm trying to tell you. Somebody made a choice. Now, why did you make this choice for the anthology? Well, because I put together what was the most important. I said, yes. And that's how the New Testament was put together. And if the world could see that in little Tori and Ed's story, that it's exactly the same. There was a committee of guys that edited it together, and if they didn't agree with it, it was out. So the gay community must become political. You need to run, be in office, make rules, make laws. It's in the law. The church is not the only law. Become active. I was saying once, okay, I love your parades, go to them, but spend less time on your silly little floats, which I love, and elevate us. Run for office, get smart, find where the power is. You put yourself seed. You need to seed yourself, seed your oats into positions and change the law or uphold the law.